My name is Arthur Treacher, and I've got a secret.
I've Got a Secret, brought to you tonight by Bristol Myers, makers of Buzzrin, the modern drug that brings relief from headache pain, protects against stomach discomfort. Bristol Myers brings you America's number one panel show, I've Got a Secret, starring Gary Moore.
Good evening. Good evening indeed, and welcome to another edition of I've Got a Secret. Before we get down to the business of playing the game, let's meet our distinguished panel. First, there's William Cullen. And next to him, there's Elizabeth Palmer.
Elizabeth.
And Heinrich Morgan. And sitting in for Bess Meyerson, who is on a short vacation, we have Carol Burnett.
Carol Burnett.
And she'll probably kill me for telling you this, but tonight is Carol Burnett's birthday. She is 15 years old tonight. Those of you who watch her know that sometimes she doesn't quite act her age, but 15 years old is what she is.
That's enough!
All right, family, all ready to play the game?
Why, sure, boy. Yeah.
Good, then may we have our first contestant come in, please. As is our custom, we will, of course, first find out who you are and where you're from. Will you give me that information, please?
My name is Marty Reisman, and I'm from New York City.
Marty Reisman from New York City, and your name, sir?
Martin Das from New York City, also.
Martin Das. D-O-S-S. Now, Martins, if you will whisper your secret to me, we will show it at the same time to our audience at home. Here we go. Well, now, that's interesting, but there's more. That's... Oh, boy. Panel, the clue to their secret concerns something they're going to do, and we'll start at the top of the batting order tonight with Bill Cullen, please.
Gentlemen, I apologize because of your
sartorial
elegance.
Splendor.
The splendor. They made me forget the question for bringing up. Does the fact that even though you are dressed delightfully tonight, that you are both wearing white, soft-soled type tennis shoes have anything to do with your secret?
I would say so, yes.
Yes, you get a yes answer to both Bill and Betsy.
I think I've helped you all enough. This thing you're going to do, fellas, will be sort of athletic, in a sense.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. It will require an amount of agility.
Fair amount of agility.
Shall you or will you do this to each other as opposed to doing it to any of the lovable panel members? Or our lovable moderator.
I suppose so.
You will just do it among
$20 down, $60 to go. We go, please, to Betsy.
Do you have
Betsy,
to wear...
Betsy, excuse me. Everybody asked me now. For the last 2 weeks, you wore your hair down the back of your neck a little girl style. Tonight, you're back to Betsy again.
Aren't I grown up tonight?
Why the change all of a sudden? Our lady listeners are interested in this.
Well, every girl, you know, likes that variety of the spice, I think. I mean, really, you know, who wants to be the same all the time? Inside we are, but on the outside we like to jazz.
All right, there's no deep, dark reason for it.
No, not at all.
All righty, so we've established only that this is an athletic contest.
Wouldn't I look funny last week bouncing along with my hair all pulled back?
You look marvelous while you were playing drums.
Well, I was just going to say, do you have to do, are you going to do something where you should grip pretty well with your feet? Is that why you have the sneaks on?
Well, I think my feet are necessary.
And sure-footed displays a certain part of it.
It does. Ripley. And now, do you use something along with your, besides just yourself?
Yes.
For instance, like a tennis racket or a ping-pong ball?
Something of that nature, yes. $40 down, $40 to go. We go, please, to Henry Morgan.
Well, then, gentlemen, is it a game?
Yes, it is.
Is it a game that uses a racket or a bat? Or whatever.
Yes, it is.
Yeah. Is it battledore and what do you call that?
Shuttle.
Badminton.
Battledore and shuttlecock?
Badminton.
Shuttlecock.
Badminton?
Badminton.
Badminton. Do you play badminton?
Nope.
Is it a game similar to that?
I wouldn't say so.
Is it like, yours? Three-wall...
squash. Bad and ping-pong.
High-life. No.
$60 down, $20 to go. We go, please, to Carol Burnett.
Is it bigger than a bread box? That's our wrong show. Does one of you leave the air? I mean, leave the ground?
I can't.
Yeah, sometimes you go up and down. Are you, like, do acrobatic things? You go up the side of the wall and jump on each other?
No, but if they ever do, I'll certainly buy tickets.
You need these shoes to do this. You run around a lot?
Mm,
yeah. And you have a bat. Does it have holes in it like a tennis racket?
Is it
solid? Is it a bat?
Is it solid? It's solid. As a matter of fact, what was your Henry's remark to Betsy just a moment ago?
He said it wasn't ping pong.
Well, as a matter of fact, it isn't, because ping pong is a trade name.
Table tennis
is the proper name, particularly the way these fellows play it. They're both champions. Their secret is that they're going to play table tennis using three balls at one time.
Take a look at this. Let's play. This is too hip for you. I'll slow down. Survey set. 100, 200, 300, 400,
500, 600, 700 more. Hold it. Let's play. Gentlemen, if you go and get your table set up, I'll move my desk out of the way.
Oh, I like that.
And while they are so doing, I'll fill you in on these two young gentlemen so you'll know the caliber of the players you're watching. Marty Reisman was the U.S. table tennis champion in 1958 and 60. He has also won the English, Canadian, and South American titles. He holds 15 national and international titles in all. Martin Doss held two Canadian titles and 10 different state titles in the United States. Now, before they play with three balls, I'll give you a little warm-up here and some trick shots. The way they play it, you can see how... Oops! And point one for Martin Reisman. We're not playing points, of course.
Gee, they're almost as good as I am.
Well, they play hard, don't they? Look at that. Now he's got him on the run. Now you see why they need the shoes. Now he's really got him on the run.
Woo! He's just standing there.
Now, if you get bored with your end of the table, go down the other end. The change of scene never heard of. Whoops!
Ow!
Around the back. Look at that. Oh, under the leg. A little stronger breath the second time and the third time. Those of you who have trouble with one ball, look at this. Two.
Oh, my.
And the denouement, three at a time. Is that good enough for you?
Thank you very much. Martin Doss, thank you so much, gentlemen. Your money will be waiting for you off stage.
Now then, if you had lived in Tennessee about 50 years ago, here's how you might have tried to relieve a sinus headache. Instructions were that you get your bucket and you go find a stream of water that flowed east, and east only. Then you would take the bucket and slosh the water over your head. Well, now, you don't have to take the water cure nowadays. It has gone the way of all those other superstitions that I've been telling you about. Today in Tennessee and everywhere else, people are using Bufferin to relieve a sinus headache. But, of course, many people take Bufferin for the more common kind of headache, which is the tension headache. That's because Bufferin is the modern drug for headache pain. It acts with amazing speed to give you relief. And Bufferin doesn't upset the stomach. Now, some of you good people already take Bufferin because your doctor told you to. Doctors, you know, do recommend Bufferin by name more often than any other leading brand of pain reliever. So the next time you feel a headache coming on, take my advice and take it.
Need your lawn mowed? There's a whammy for that. Want to walk the dog? There's a whammy for that. But if you want to win, there's no whammy for that.
No whammy. No whammy. Uh-oh.
Oh. Pesky little critters. Press your luck. Weekdays at 1 on BUZZR. Let's play.
Now, let's meet our next contestant, please. Sorry, I can't help you both in simultaneously, but that's the way it goes. Now, ladies, if you'll close in as close to me as you can, we'd like to find out what your names are and where you are from. We'll start with you, please.
I am Miss Delia Harris from Knoxville, Tennessee.
Miss Delia Harris of Knoxville, Tennessee. And your name, please?
Bertie Harris from Knoxville, Tennessee.
This is Miss Bertie Harris of Knoxville, Tennessee. Now, this secret of theirs, I want to tell you, sounds on the surface of it almost impossible. I assure you it has been documented, and we'll explain it later on. So, Miss Bertie and Miss Delia Harris, if you'll whisper your secret to me, we'll show it at the same time to the folks at home. Here we go. Now, panel, to help classify the Harris sisters' secret, the clue concerns a relative of theirs. And Henry, we'll start with you, I think, please.
Miss Delia Harris, is this relative of yours a famous man?
I think our opinion would be that he individually was not famous, no.
Well, was he part of a famous family?
No, that's not quite it. When we say famous, we mean somebody whose name we can say and you would immediately recognize. The answer there again is no.
You related to nobody. Were you related to somebody? Well, I mean, as part of a secret, it must be somebody we'd recognize one way or another. No?
Not necessarily.
Well, you said in the beginning it's almost unbelievable.
Yes, it is.
And it concerns a relative.
Yes.
Well, is it a woman?
No.
Well, it is a man.
Yes.
Well, does the man have a title like he was the first to do something or...
No.
All right, with $20 down, a little knowledge gained, and I don't blame you, it's tough. We go to Carol Burnett, please.
He was the last to do something. was he your brother?
No.
Your father?
No.
Your husband?
No.
You were both married to the same man.
My name is Miss.
Oh, I passed.
Too late.
I've gotten to know these two ladies. You don't get much past them. $40 down, $40 to go. We go, please, to Bill Cullen.
Father, brother, husband have been mentioned. Uncle, possibly?
No.
Blood relative?
Yes.
Cousin?
No.
Grandfather?
Yes.
You both have the same grandmother.
Well, how about that? Both of these sisters have the same grandfather.
What? Is that right? Right? No.
Remember, friends, you heard it here first.
It was a rhetorical question. Your grandfather did something, did he, in which we're interested?
Yes. Now, this is where we get back to your original area. It is not the gentleman himself whose name remains famous. It was the event with which he was connected.
Was it a Civil War event? Civil War event.
$60 down, $20 to go. What did you say, Bill?
Civil War event.
No.
No. All right, no. Then we go to Betsy Funk, please.
Well, Miss Bertie and Miss Delia, is it something that has to do with the state of Tennessee?
No.
Does it have something to do with Washington, D.C., as far as our government is concerned?
No.
It hasn't.
Oh, you scared me then. Yeah.
Does it have something to do with the state of Washington?
No.
Washington itself.
Washington himself?
No.
No.
Indirectly?
Really?
Well,
Miss Delia says no. What do you say, Miss Birdie?
Indirectly.
All right, we've lost the $80. Henry thinks he knows what it is.
This is a very remote possibility, and I'm going to do this wrong because I got the years wrong. Was your grandfather the grandson of Washington?
No. Pamela, I told you that this secret sounded impossible, and you may need a pencil and paper to follow it, but I doubt it. The secret that Miss Birdie and Miss Delia Harris share is that their grandfather, now understand this, their grandfather was a soldier in the Revolutionary War. The Revolutionary War, of course, being from 1776 to 1781. Miss Delia, when was your grandfather, Simon Harris, born?
He was born in 1766.
Well, now that would have made him 10 years old when the Revolutionary War began. He didn't get in at the age of 10. How old was he when he got in?
12. He entered as a fifer.
Uh-huh. He entered not as a soldier, but as a fifer, but subsequently he did see action, didn't he?
Yes, he was at Valley Forge with Washington's army, and then he was at Cornwallis Surrender at Yorktown.
In fact, his name is on the monument at Yorktown. Now, this is just unbelievable to think. My grandfather, be able to say my grandfather was in the Revolutionary War. Now, here's where you might need a pencil and paper to follow this. Find out how only two generations separate these ladies from the American Revolution. Simon Harris, their grandfather, was married in 1796 and he had 10 children. His youngest child and the father of these two ladies was born in 1818. So, by the way, if it isn't amazing enough that their grandfather fought in the Revolutionary War, let me tell you also that their father was too old to fight in the Civil War. Now, their father was married twice. He had 10 children by his first marriage, and 3 children by his second marriage when he was in his 70s. And of those 3 children, these two ladies are of those 3, and also another sister, Mary Lou, who is watching the show at home. Miss Delia, that's a pretty large and complicated family, isn't it?
Rather.
As a matter of fact, it's kind of interesting to know that Miss Bertie and Miss Delia have nieces and nephews who are older than they are. Isn't that true, Miss Bertie?
Very true.
Well, Miss Delia, Miss Bertie Harris, I want to thank you so much for sharing your secret with us tonight. Your money and your Bristol-Myers gift package will be waiting for you backstage. It's been a rare privilege. Now, panel, inasmuch as the Mrs. Harris have been content to leave the stage, I'm going to have to ask you to be equally cooperative. Go to the soundproof room, if you will. We'll call you back as soon as ever we can. But right now, let's see if you can guess the answer to this important question. Does she or doesn't she?
Every season, every age has its own special beauty. But the quality of freshness never loses its appeal. Her hair so soft and shiny, the color fresh, sparkling. Does she or doesn't she? Miss Clairol hair color looks so natural, only her hairdresser knows for sure. Yet just after the baby was born, she caught a glimpse of herself. Her hair seemed lifeless, so faded. Then she tried Miss Clairol. Now she looks as wonderful as she feels. Miss Clairol really covers gray. Keeps hair color young, radiant, sparkling with life. So beautifully soft and silky.
Nice.
Miss Clairol Hair Color Bath. The natural looking hair coloring. So quick and easy.
Weekdays are great days for great action.
He's having a great time with you, Dave. We're going to have a great contest.
Great excitement.
Isn't that great?
Doesn't that put us in a great light here?
I've been great. I'm thrilled to be here.
Great fun.
All-time great.
Great matchups.
Great.
Great. Great.
Great. Great.
It's a great way to spend the day.
Isn't that a great deal?
Great.
Great.
Greater.
Greatest.
Very nice indeed.
It's great. You'll see.
Daytime buzz. It's great. Weekdays starting at 10, only on BUZZR. Let's play.
Now, my friends, let's greet our special guest for tonight. He is a frequent visitor to our show simply because he is so much fun to have around. With a great deal of affection, we present Mr. Arthur Treacher.
Thank you.
Arthur? Arthur? Excuse me for being nosy, but why are you sitting on that horse?
Well, if I were up here without the horse, I'd look pretty preposterous, wouldn't I?
I suppose if you're so tall, I'm going to have to get a hand microphone.
If you will. Yeah.
All right. Now, Arthur, did you bring a secret with you along with the horse?
Yes, I'm delighted to tell it to you. As a matter of fact, my secret is that I'm going to give this horse to Henry Morgan. Whoa.
You mean actually give it to him in toto as a gift?
In toto, yes. As a matter of fact, I'm delighted to do it. I'll tell you why. I'm so sick and tired of people saying that actors and people in the profession aren't good businessmen.
Yes.
You see, I want to prove to the people that they say also that, you know, professional men can't either wheel or deal, whatever that means.
So you're going to give the horse to Henry, then what does he then do with it?
Well, my dear fella, I want to find out if he's any good as a horse trader.
Oh, he's going to get a chance to trade the horse.
Yeah.
Now, with whom or to whom?
Anybody who's listening to this program tonight. Anybody at all, whether here or anywhere. But I got details of that later.
All right, now listen, you heard what Mr. Treacher said. Get a pencil and paper, because we're deadly serious about this. One of you out there in our audience is going to end up owning this horse if you can come up with something that's worthwhile Henry trading you for. So get a pencil and paper. We'll give you the details a little later on. And that's the secret, is that you're simply giving Henry the horse.
Well, that's a pretty good secret, isn't it?
I would say so. All right, let's get the panel back in, please.
There you are.
You have a magnificent seat, if I may say so,
well,
sir.
Well, sir, I didn't know you could see it.
You spent a great deal of time in horsemanship, Arthur?
Well, I've ridden a lot, my boy, yes.
Here we go. You all know Arthur Treacher up here.
Oh, of course. I love
it. All right, now this secret concerns something that he is going to do.
Why, Henry? Oh, I think it's wonderful. That's the greatest sight I ever saw on this show.
Well, we'll go to Carol Burnett, I think, who is here in the absence of Bess Meyerson. Carol, it's something he's going to do. There's that unfortunate laugh again.
You look so silly.
Silly?
Are you going to jump?
No.
Is the horse going to sit down?
I hope not.
Is this something you're going to do on the horse?
No.
You're going to do it off the horse?
No. Well,
you're going to do it halfway in the horse.
Well, at the very moment of consummation of what he's going to do, he will be afoot.
Is it a good horse?
Speaks very well of you, dear.
Does the horse belong to you?
Yes, for certain purposes, yes.
$20 down, $60 to go, and we go, please, to Bill Cullen.
I've known Arthur for years, and I can really guess this in one fell swoop. He's going to fall off the horse.
That isn't the secret of what.
Although you might.
What?
Arthur, after you dismount, are you going to do something to the horse?
Yes.
Oh, for goodness sake.
Rather, Arthur, shall we correct that to say with rather than to?
You're going
to do something with
the horse. Yes.
I see. Are you going to, for instance, with the horse? You wouldn't shoe the horse, because
you're
going to make him a horse of another color.
No.
You're going to put him in someone's bathtub.
$40 down, $40 to go. Betsy Palmer, you're on.
Dear Pip, are you going to do this here tonight?
Yes.
Oh. Are you going to do something about, like, removing that saddle and stirrups and things like that? You have a lasso on the side. Are you going to lasso somebody or something?
No.
All right, we've lost $60. We have Henry Morgan between us and oblivion. Henry?
Arthur, is that a trick horse?
No. Whoa.
He's leaving.
Now, it was established you're going to do something with the horse.
Yes.
Now, what does a man...
All right, Henry, I think the best way for you to find out is if you will please come front and center out here, please.
Yes,
stand approximately by him.
I have to turn the horse round because they begged me to dismount on the other side.
All right, we'll turn the horse round. Good night, folks. We're a little late.
All right. Yeah. It's all right. Now, I have to get off the horse.
Yes, all right. Now, we'll hold the reins here, Henry, while Arthur dismounts.
Now, I've dismounted.
Yes?
Now.
You come around here now. The horse is all yours, and what is do you supposed to do with it?
Well, I'm going to give it to you, Henry, my dear boy.
Wait. First, I want to know, am I allowed to look in his mouth?
Yes. But
because the gift horse...
You must not look at
him. You don't look at him.
Here are the reins. My dear Henry Morgan, this is your horse.
How big is your partner?
Wait a minute. I'm supposed to be a good talker.
Well, Henry, before you ride off into the sunset...
Thanks a lot. thanks, Arthur. Thanks. I wish I had known I would have gotten a little something for you. A herd of cows.
Before you leave, well, that's a good point to it. Don't worry about a thing. Let me assure you, this horse is a good home and a stable here in town, so you don't have to take him to your apartment. Arthur's actually giving you this as a gift in order to find out how good a horse trader you are. Now, some people think that performers have no business sense, that we don't know how to handle ourselves. You have an opportunity to prove or disprove this theory.
Can I have a raise? I'm asking you in front of America.
Get off the horse.
You're asking
fun? No.
No. Now, it all depends upon how shrewd a trader you are, and we have some rules to read about this contest.
Yes. Anyone who is watching this program tonight at any place in the United States or Canada is eligible to make Henry an offer.
Now, if you want Henry's horse, and you have something to trade for it, and we're serious, this is what you do.
Up next, people are actually rewarded for telling lies on To Tell the Truth. Then just try to guess how these folks make a living on What's My Line. Stay tuned.
Now, please, do not send any money. Do not send any letters. Do not send any merchandise. Your offer for whatever you want to trade Henry for his horse.
I'm beginning
has
to like
be
him. Maybe I don't want to trade.
Postcards must be postmarked no later than midnight Friday, April the 28th, 1961.
Now, Henry, you
and must be in our hands by Monday, May the 1st.
May 1st is the deadline.
Wait a minute.
Whoa. Henry, you are the sole judge. It's up to you to decide what you want to exchange for the horse. You will accept what you think is the best offer next week on this program. And now, Henry, if you'll get on your horse, there's a van waiting outside. If you'll ride him off. Oh, he knows which side to get on. That's something.
Well, I saw which side Arthur got off.
Careful, Henry. You're getting on backwards.
I have the great pleasure to welcome Arthur, too, not only to tonight's show, but next Tuesday night, we're going to be together on the Variety Show, too. Rehearsal at 10 o'clock tomorrow morning.
And don't be late.
I'm sorry. So, I know Bess thanks you for filling in for her. Thank you so much, dear.
Thank you.
And Bill Cullen, you go on a 2 weeks vacation, you lazy rat.
I do that, and I am that.
Have a good time.
Thank you, Gary.
And
I'm
so,
with you.
Goodbye out there.
WCOP Channel 9 to the I've Got a Secret family. We'll be seeing you here each Wednesday night. Miss Palmer's Gown by Madeline B. Friedman. Bristol Myers also brings you Candid Camera. Salt your local listing for time and day. I've Got a Secret is brought to you by Bristol Myers.